Hello everyone, this is me Satya here and I'm doing your third week of June reading, start from the 15th to the 21st of June 2020. This is going to be for the sign of Taurus. So let's find out what is heading towards you guys for this week time. While I am shuffling the cards, let me remind you, it's a general reading, it may not resonate with everyone out there. So always pick the messages which resonate with you in your situation and leave the rest. For personal readings, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box, and you can also follow me on Instagram where I do upload daily readings. You can also check out my sister's tarot channel. I will be adding the link to her channel in the comment section. If you like it, you can always become a part of her YouTube family as well. I will be taking out oracle cards in this reading, but no charms, so stay tuned. So let's see. You're starting off the week with the Chariot. That means your life is going to, it's going to seem like, everything is under control as you start off the week. It's more of that, energy when you know that now you know how to deal with situations. You are so sure that whatever comes, you will be able to handle it. Be that in your love life, work life, home life situation, it's like, you are prepared mentally, physically, and emotionally to deal with it. You don't want to run away from it. You are ready to go for it. You are ready to deal with it. You are ready to face it. Whatever it is, a relationship situation, a work life situation, whatever it is, it seems like, you are finally prepared and you know that what you need to do and what you got to do to deal with it. I feel like, August is going to be a significant month for you regarding the situation, whatever it is, that you are going to be dealing with, whatever it is that you're making, that is basically, making you feel like, you're ready for it, whatever it is, if it's a relationship, if it's a commitment, whatever it is, you will be going for it in the month of August. So it can be, if it applies to your love life, I feel like, maybe you are ready to take, your relationship serious, and you are going to take this relationship to the next level in the month of August. I feel like, August is going to be a very key month for you. Maybe July through the August is going to be very significant for you regarding something that you are going to start thinking you are ready for it. So I feel like, it's going to be something related to your love life, but it can be in any other area of your life as well. But I feel like, month of August is going to be very significant for you. But yes, you are, feeling empowered, you are feeling ready, you are feeling pretty much, on top of the game. Two of Wands. You're ready to start something with someone. Seems like, it is something which you are definitely not ready to face before. It is something that you were never ready to, maybe, if it's a commitment thing, I feel like, you are feeling prepared for, going for that. But having said that, it's if there is a person in your life that you really want to start a relationship with, maybe you are going to reach out to this person, maybe you are going to talk and express your feelings to this person, but you are going to start something together, not this week time. It's you are going to communicate, you are going to talk, you are going to feel good about, doing so. But like I said, something new, like a new beginning in terms of marriage, commitment, that's going to happen in the month of August. Eight of Wands, you will be communicating with this person a lot during this time. It is definitely going to make you very happy doing so. But your struggle with your mind chatter will continue during this week time regarding this person. Even though everything seems perfect, everything's like, like I said in the beginning, like, you would feel like, you have control over everything right now. But there will be days, there will be times when you will have your, that struggle with your inner self, with the inner, the mind chatter, I would say. It's not about the inner self, it's more of the mind chatter that you would be having regarding this, and every day is going to be a new struggle for you to deal with that mind chatter. But I do see that you are going to get very happy being with this person, being, feeling ready to go for this connection, because it does make you feel very happy. It does make you feel like going for it. You really want to take charge of the situation. You really want to go for this connection with this specific someone. Let's see who this person is, because I feel like, there is this one person, Queen of Swords and Knight of Swords. Somebody who is very clear in their mind, somebody who's very clear in their head. It can be your own energy, by the way, as well, because the energies are general. So, you know, the readings are general, so the energies could come reversed as well. So somebody, you know, this person is somebody who, you know, whoever it is that you are dealing with, I feel like, you know, it's somebody who is very clear in their mind, what they want, how they want it to be. But I feel like, you know, this person talks a lot, or either you talks a lot. You know, it's something that, you know, once you start, you don't stop. It's that kind of energy. And this person is somebody from your past. Yeah. Judgment paired up with the Six of Cups. It's like, you know, you are talking to someone from your past for sure. But you were not ready, or they were not ready, but now you both are ready to go for this connection. And I feel like, you know, whoever this person is, either they talk a lot or you talk a lot. And that could have been, you know, one of the issues too. But maybe you didn't have time for this person. Maybe they didn't have time for you. And now you both are, you know, coming together. You are talking a lot this week time. You are going to start something beautiful together. But yes, it's going to be... even if you're a cross watcher or a Taurus person yourself, I would suggest you to do one thing. Don't let your mind chatter sway you away from this, you know, this energy that you are carrying right now in the beginning of the week. Don't let that happen. Like, don't let your mental talk that you would be having with yourself, that too, you know, the negative one, don't let that affect you or let you take or think of any negative thought, because it's just gonna ruin the whole thing up. So don't let that happen. Just know that everything is under control. Everything is exactly how you want it to be. So just go with that belief. Go with that, you know, firm believe in the outcome that you desire with this person. For some of you, you might be, or the person, you know, that you are dealing with, they are, you know, manifesting this connection. And again, you know, the inner chatter is of that one person who is manifesting this connection, because it seems like, you know, there will be times when the person is going to question themselves. You know, even though I've, you know, done this and then that, like, you know, this person is still not making a move forward. So again, you really have to shut that, you know, mind chatter and listen to, you know, just go with that firm belief that you starting off the week with, and you will get what you want. And I do see that, you know, there is a lot of communication coming for you for this week time with this specific person. But again, August month is going to be very significant for the two of you and for this connection that you have with this specific person. Let's see what the Oracle has to add to the reading for you guys for this week time. Let's see. You deserve love and you are lovable. I would suggest you to make affirmations around this person, around this connection, whether you are in touch, whether you are not, whether you are... you know, in touch, but, you know, things are kind of, you know, moving slow. You can start making affirmations around your connection, so it pace up, you know, pace up the speed. You may, you know, name the person, like, you know, suppose the name of the person is James. James has proposed me. James has been texting me a lot. And I'm loving it, you know, something around those lines. You can always reach out to me for affirmations if you want my, you know, spiritually charged affirmations, but you can make your own as well. So you using affirmations is definitely going to speed up the process for you. And, but yeah, I feel like, you know, a lot of communication is happening between the two of you. And the more you communicate, the more you're going to come closer to each other. And again, the only thing that you need to be very careful with is the mind chatter. Don't let that distract you. And let's see what color is going to be lucky for you for this week time. Coral, allow flow and synchronicity into your life. Number 18, 18th could be the date when you are going to receive message from this person if you are in no communication with this person right now. This shade of orange, like peachy orange, is going to be lucky for you. You can also wear a coral stone if you want. You can see that, you know, things, you know, the moment you start off the week, you can see that things are finally getting, you know, back to normal. Even though you might not see something positive right now, but yes, you would have the sense of satisfaction. And that's going to come if you shut this, you know, mind chatter. That's what you will be having in the back of your mind still in this week as well. But you really need, like, you know, to start off this week with this positive energy, you really have to shut this up. Once you do that, you will see that everything is going to start working well for you. You will, receive the message, you will talk to this person is, giving you more and more time now, and, everything is going, smoothly between the two of you. And that's how you're gonna, how, either you are manifesting this person or this person is manifesting you. So everything is going to be good. But again, make sure you don't, mind chatter or disturb you in any way, like, any thought which creates negative emotion in you, or which triggers a negative emotion in you. You really need to switch it there and then start affirming something positive. Like I said, James is ready to, James is messaging me 24/7, or James is like, asking me to meet him every single day, or whatever it is. Like, you can, whatever the name of the person is, you can name that person's, add the name of that person, and then, add something beautiful that you want to come your way. From this person, you can do that, and that's gonna be very helpful to let go of the negative trigger that you might have during this week time. So yeah, let's see one more card from the Oracle deck. Let's see what it has to add to the reading for you guys for this week time. True healing occurs when I give myself permission to feel whatever feelings live below the triggers. Again, the trigger thing that I mentioned, just go and follow that. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming up for you for this week time. If the reading resonates with you, do like, subscribe, and share. If you're willing to get a personal reading, you can always reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box. Till I do the next reading for you guys, take care. Bye-bye.